In this video, we'll show you 24 cable exercises and variations you're probably not doing. Exercises that'll give you more effective precision training. With free weights, the amount of resistance changes across the movement. Less here, more here, less again here. Cables give you constant resistance throughout your rep. But, just as important, there's a wide range of grips and angles that many trainers miss. To target the muscle more precisely. So, today, we'll guide you through all the key cable exercises for chest, shoulders, back, and arms. Bars are great for chest because you can load them with a heavy weight. But the movement path is fixed. Dumbbells give you a greater range of movement. But when you get to the top, there's no resistance. At this point, you're just balancing the weights. The pec muscles hardly working at all. Now here's the cable version, with constant resistance across the movement. Including at that key point, maximum contraction of the muscle. Changing the angle lets you target different parts of the chest. Here, you're working more on lower chest. For middle chest, cables are level with the shoulders. With the choice of regular grip, or hammer grip. And to work more on upper chest, a low to high variation. For all these exercises, there's the option of both arms or alternating arms, giving you multiple variations to hit the muscles in different ways. Coming up, the 10 best cable exercises to take your arms training to the next level. Free weights give you a chance to go heavy on shoulders. But as we saw with chest, the resistance is less at the top of the movement. Effective shoulder training is more about isolation, targeting the three muscles of the shoulder, front, middle, and rear delt. Cables are ideal for isolation, but many trainers miss out on the multiple options for grips and angles that cables provide. That low to high cable raise is an exercise mainly for chest, front delts working as the secondary muscle. But by changing to hammer grip, you can work more on the front delt. So it's now more of a shoulder exercise. Isolate the shoulder even more by moving to single arm. Body position is important for all these front raises. Standing close to the rack for constant resistance on the front delts. For middle delts, this is a side hang lateral raise with a full stretch at the bottom and a full squeeze at the top. Plus, the option of bringing the cable to different positions, behind the body, or to the middle. Hitting a different angle each time. For rear delts, a high cable crossover. Also working traps and middle back. Changing the angle of the cable to target the muscles you want. On the bent over version, taking the arms out to the sides is more for rear delts. By taking a step forward, you can create a different angle. To put more effort on the middle back. But for strict isolation of the rear delts, these are face pulls. Setting the cable to the optimal angle for hitting those rear delt muscles. The back is trained using a wide range of pulling movements. With cables used for many standard back day exercises. Often with a choice of handles and grips. But even with so many options, a lot of trainers still miss out on key variations to take their training to the next level. For the bent over row, there's multiple options. Changing to a rope to bring the elbows out wider. Working a different angle on the lats. For all these pulling exercises, moving to single arm can help give you an extra squeeze at the top of the movement, especially by adding a twist. And for a different angle, try a kneeling position. Changing the way you hit the back muscles from one workout to the next. When you're looking to build bigger arms, you probably head straight for the dumbbells. But arm movements with dumbbells have the same limitations we saw on other body parts. Minimal resistance here and here. On this cable curl, standing one step back from the pulley, you have constant resistance for the whole movement. Most people use underhand grip for this exercise. Changing to overhand grip works more on the brachialis, a muscle that sits under the bicep, which can make the arm look thicker. Ropes give you a kind of a hammer grip. Working more on the outside of the bicep, the long head. If you've tried incline bench bicep curl, you'll know that having the elbows set behind the body also gives an excellent stretch on the long head. But you can get the same effect with cables. Elbows set behind the body to help you build added thickness to the bicep. Triceps training is all about hitting that lockout at the bottom of the movement. The squeeze is where the triceps working hardest. So you're looking for maximum resistance at the point where the arm is straight. Cable pushdown is a go-to exercise for triceps. With overhand grip most popular. Changing to underhand puts slightly more emphasis on the largest of the three tricep muscles, the long head. Hammer grip is also popular. But in general, grip variations don't make that much difference on triceps, as long as you hit that straight arm lockout. So try single arm. And different grips. Finding an option that works for you. Whether it's with single or double handles, as long as you're getting that full contraction on the tricep, the exercise is working. Often forgotten is the overhead tricep extension. For a great stretch on the long head of the tricep and a perfect lockout as you reach fully forward. So, that's our guide to some of the many cable options you can add to your weekly workout mix. For more exercise demonstrations, head over to the Fit Media website for our complete exercise database.